Celtic Sports. This is Herpy. Now today I'm going to be talking about the madness that took place off Red Hills Road, a place called Park Lane. Now originally when the news was reported, you were hearing that, well, the seven, right, the amount of people that end up pick up rounds, that was consistent. That was always seven. But then the amount of people actually passed away. Right? Some sources were saying four. Some news sources are saying three. Right, as it stands right now, where you saw officially a three, we don't know what's going to happen with some of the people in Moran Hospital. But of course, that's just the nature of news. When a major incident takes place, there's normally, sometime you hear three, sometime you hear four, then the next thing turns out to two. That's just how news go. Right, that obviously information is coming in fast, right, and people want to get this story out there. Man, the hospital, oh, him gone. Oh, hold on, Dr. Steve, him, alright, so. That's just part of the whole news business. So not too worried about that. But as it stands, a three. But seven one time. Think about that for a second. In an instant, one drive-by, seven people. One life when you realize how serious this is. You see, you have to understand now. 87s, no say, right? For example, that bar, right? That shop, this time of day, full up of people. So it's not like, say, they have to run down the seven people, you know, right? Wanting to understand how these things go down, you know. When you hear these big numbers, it's normal because them catch the people them grouped up at a single location, right? It's not like 87s are these highly trained marksmen who pick off people at distances of 200 meters. People bungle up, right? Have a couple drinks. Or you hear people that play domino, but people bungle up. This make it easy for them to drive past, do what they might do, right? Sometimes they even come out of the vehicle, right? For, you know, finish what they might do. But more often than not, they don't have to do that. They just pull up, lay down a barrage around, and then when the smoke clear, you hear say, well, seven people pick up, right? Rounds three pass away. As far as 87s are concerned, their job is done. Right? Because if you understand, this is not just a case of, oh, them just want to make a dopey. What they're trying to do is instill terror in other people. Right? This is an act of terror. They might try to instill fear in other people, I mean, sir. Right? Via committing an act of terror. Because now when the people in a Park Lane, you say, seven people stand up on a corner, or seven people pick up rounds after standing up on a corner, what I do know is people that say, well, you know what, turn in at the yard. Pity them say, mommy, daddy, mo go play. No, turn in at the yard. Mo go shop. No, turn in at the yard. You have to understand, right? So, right, that is why I say this is an act of terror, because they are waging psychological warfare upon the residents them in these quote-unquote Batman place. And it's been done by your favorite criminals. It's been done by your favorite gangs. People need to realize that this is what badness look like. When they hear the pull up on the ends and everybody will miss you, I get it, and we just wet up the whole place and who dead does that. This is what it look like in our real life. You see, Park Lane, 100 Lane, obviously a long time in place to have them issues. But you, the tragedy about a Park Lane. As the name suggests, you would have one long lane on one side, a wall against the next side. Forget about 100 Lane versus Park Lane. You'd have Park Lane and the top part of Park Lane at it with the bottom part. When if you understand, say, a friend, a kill friend, neighbor, I kill neighbor. No, for the people that are at it now, right? They go to the same school. Even when 100 Lane and Park Lane are for them problem, no, for the people who are at it, them grew up together. They go to the same school and walk on the same road and go to the same food shop, go buy food. As a matter of fact, that's also one of the reasons why it's so easy for them to strike. Right? They're literally neighbors. They know each other. So this right here, so, man, from what we're hearing, a retaliation for your previous incident. But guess what? It's always retaliation. They might answer back for man, oh, you think so you can come do this to me? Alright, what will happen to you? And then when something like this happen, man say, alright, when you come pull up on our ends, what up 7 people, alright, what will happen to you? And he go back and forth and back and forth. And Pitney can't walk on the road. Nobody can play. Park Lane, 100 Lane, enough communities in Jamaica, period. They are virtual prisons for residents. People come out in the morning because them have to go to work and them have to go to school. But as them reach back in, them lock up in the yard. So even though Big C restrictions might be new for enough of Jamaica, for many residents who live in some of these troubled communities, they've been having restrictions their whole life. Restrictions imposed by 87s. Restrictions imposed by criminals. The psycho people say, alright, stay indoors, tan in your yard. That way you can avoid the Big C. Well, people hear that all them life. 100 Lane, Park Lane. And the unfortunate reality is that not just from the perspective of the loss of life, which obviously is the most important thing, but when it comes down to the economic side to it, when it comes down to the general development of the community, when if you understand, say, the ongoing feud while going on Reduce Road, it stifles any kind of growth and development because shop of luck, bar of luck, people, remember say Park Lane, if I'm not mistaken, right beside Park Lane, there is like a stretch of Pan Chicken. Right now, it's been a while, but back in the day, some of the best Pan Chicken you could buy. Right, at this, so right, we used to pass through and get some Pan Chicken. Right, I mean, I know how I go on now, right, but back in the day, that was the spot. You pull up, right, you can park your car, eat your Pan Chicken. Right, then time you could buy the chicken, Pan Chicken, stand up there and eat it as long as you want. Right. Buy two juice, hold two reasoning, right? To the place I run now, nobody now linger nowhere near Park Lane. Nobody now linger nowhere near Reduce Road, at least to that side. Because of the madness. The little shop where, you know, the lady might have, she sell a little 2 and 3 juice that she have to rely upon. Them they have to lock up. Right. And even if they open, nobody now to go down there. People have to desperate. People rather buy things from, for example, off a tree and carry it in the yard, then go in the yard, go walk pan shop, back and forth, go shop. Because it's just too risky if you left the yard and just, you know, and get caught or walk pan the road, because them place are some place where just being related to the wrong 87, right, will cost your life. The 87 of them know when for lay low and take with themselves, you know, but them family members are left behind. Their friends are left behind, their neighbors are left behind, and the man them no business. Then just one knows, oh, she related to him, see how you walk, come up from the shop, and then they'll wipe you out just like that. And even though it's small in terms of, if you are measured by miles, you have to understand that 87 them know every corner, every nook and cranny. Because you think of just a lane, right? Police should be able to just go around there, lock it down, search and find everything going around there. It's a tricky place. Tricky place. Same for 100 Lane. No for the lane. There are quite a few lanes are for this road, but you know, 100 Lane and Park Lane are probably some of the most infamous because they name constantly in the news. And even police park up, because 100 Lane or Park Lane are some place where police will park in the lane. And 87 just sit down and watch them whole day. Right. Because guess what? Them know say you must left. You can't park this off river. And as soon as the police them left, they hear say man drop. So just having a quote unquote police presence is not enough. Right. You're gonna need intelligence driven operations. That means the residents them have to work with the police. I know them think they go already. People here from them here, they need say, don't talk to the police. Don't be the informer. I understand that drilling the people head, but them see say, 87s, not care about nobody. Them see say, the man them willing, right, to turn it on by any group of people them catch. Right. You just have to be related to the wrong smelly, you just have to know the wrong smelly. So sooner or later, something have to give. Security forces need to play for them part, obviously. But the residents need to play for them on too. A spooky situation. Very unfortunate. Me say back in the day, used to love go get pan chicken in your park lane. So drive far, forget it. There was a bad jerk stand, a little jerk pan you see there near park lane. So drive far and long just to check that specific jerk pan there. But like many things and many places in Jamaica, when you talk about them things, they have to talk about the quote unquote good old days, because you know, when you go already, slowly but surely, once the madness start, then you have to find a new spot for end zone, right? Because nobody no one then away where you have to constantly, right, I look over your shoulder and I constantly, and then you say, all right, come and go buy this, and after people say, I'm not going up because park lane down the road, I'm not going to your park lane. So eventually just find the next spot. As me say, badness hurt poor people. Badness hurt trying working people, right? I have a video saying, showing how, right, gang warfare affect inner city economic development. It's a shame, right? But hopefully soon we're going to use the police will ramp on somebody and they can get some convictions, right? But when I read stories like this, it truly blow my mind that kerosene can really go protest for some of them man. A group of man can pull up, see one bar, see one shop, see one man walk on the road, we don't do them nothing. And I stand in time upon them like nothing, like say, I just stand there at the office, and then when them man they lose them life, them go fake ball and fake protest, it just truly blow my mind. Because when you see the pain and misery with criminals, bring down upon the community. When you see the death and destruction, when you see, right, the stagnant growth, the party can't put on, right, the bar can't open. And your favorite criminals are caused that. And I would love to say, it look like the end is near for, you know, the madness and it seems, but a long time this is going on. Even time, you see, you don't have to understand. When we talk about culture, no? When an 100 lane and park lane man them at it, right? And the lane them are splitting a two, right? And I go at it. So even time old enemies mend fences, man end up find new enemies. Complete chaos. Anyway, patience squad, big up on yourself. PIA, I don't know, more life. Culture squad, stay circling. Bless.